Đi đây là một đồng ý.
Okay. How are you?
Yes, I am feeling very good today.
Ready for the test?
Yes, I am.
Okay. Let's start. Don't worry if the time is. Now, firstly, what is your full name?
My full name is Nguyễn, Bình, Dương.
Okay. For the first part of the test, I'm going to ask you some general questions. Let's talk about bicycles. Did you ride a bike, a bicycle, when you were a child?
When I was a child, I used to love the bicycle. I rode it every single day after school.
Do you ride a bicycle now?
I would have it. It wasn't for my bicycle being broken again.
Are bicycles popular in your country?
Yes, it is. It even is kind of traditional figure of Vietnamese culture.
Do you think bicycles will be more or less popular in the future?
As more people are interested in environmental changes, I do think that the trend of using bicycles instead of personal cars are increasing nowadays.
See, let's talk about singing. Did you do a lot of singing when you were at primary school?
When I was at primary school, I was not that interested in singing in general, but I had to sing in my subject, as a subject in school.
How often do you sing now?
Now I am more interested in music and in general, and I both listen and sing music, and I sing every day, like 2 or 4 songs a day.
Okay. Who is your favorite singer?
My favorite singer. They are a band. It is Adam Levine from the Maroon 5.
Do you think the words of a song are as important as the music?
Some people, they view a song. It depends on the people. Some people think that songs are like poems and they have deeper meanings inside. And some who listen for the tune, the instruments being played. But I personally do think that the meaning behind the lyrics of the song, it very much matters, and it adds layers to the piece overall.
Okay, thank you very much. And that is the first part of the test. Okay, let's move to part two. In the second part, I'm going to give you a topic card, and you will have the limit to make any notes about this topic. After 1 minute, I will stop you, and then you're supposed to talk about this topic for 2 minutes long. Okay, 1 minute to think. That's it.
Something that made me feel very proud after I have done it is definitely by learning how to play the flute. the straight flute, the accordion flute. At first I had no interest at all in the flute, and even at some point I didn't know that it existed in the first place. But in my secondary school, it got introduced to me as a subject in music class, and everyone had to get one on their own, and I also did. I started playing the songs that the teacher recommended, and I saw the beauty of it, and I really liked it. And I started practicing playing, learning notes and songs on my own in my free time. One thing and the main reason why I did it at the first place was all the time I spent playing it and the practicing that I did. A major difficulty was how I handled the flute. As you may know, that the flute is being played by plugging the holes in the flute to play different sounds. At first I was struggling so much, I didn't even know which hand was above and which hand was below. But after I watched tutorials, I practiced for myself, and I even asked a friend of mine who really likes music. I soon got the hang of it, and I really was getting better and better at it. The reason why I really felt proud of it is because my parents really wanted me to play an instrument since when I was young, so they took me to piano lessons, but I didn't get along well with the piano, so after I did that, playing the flute, I recognize that I have done something, and that really cheered me on. And also my parents were very proud of me, and that was the main reason why I felt very grateful for being able to play the flute.
Thank you. Do you think you will still play the flute in the future?
To the distant future, I think that I may move to string musical instruments, like say the guitar or the ukulele, because the flute, now I know the hang of it. Everyone who learns how to play an instrument, they almost certainly experience a time when they don't really like it anymore, like they are uninterested, they lose interest. So I am currently in the point of having the flute.
Thank you. That was the second part of the test. Now, moving on to the third one. I'm going to ask you some more general questions related to the topic that you have just discussed. My first question is, which is more important, personal goals or work goals?
So about personal goals, I have learned from the past, since I was young, that setting goals was one of the most important skills that a person can have. And I have put many goals on my future, and currently I'm on the path on every single of them. My first and maybe my closest goal is to achieve a formidable score in the IELTS paper, and I am currently progressing on it. I am collecting all of my of the past papers and doing them, and that is how I keep track of my progress on my current goal on the IELTS paper exam.
Okay, so have your life goals changed since your childhood?
Since my childhood, my life goal was to become a scientist. As my impression of a scientist when I was young was people wearing lab coats. They look so cool with goggles, and they hold out bottles of dangerous chemicals that sometimes go wrong. But now I think that now I have grown up more, and I think that I should choose a career, a life goal, which more closely resembles the current trend of the society, like for example, say computer science and designing and programming.
So, do you think that everyone sets goals for themselves?
I do not think that everyone set goals for myself as a or mainly educated people. They know that setting goals in life is a very important decision and that everyone should make goals. But some people don't have proper education and they don't think much about the future. For say they just want to have a okay job, with okay paying, and to get them by the day with their meals. And also some people, they overthink their life goals too much. For say people who chase rhetorical life goals, they say, what does this life mean? Like, what is the meaning of everything? And those people, I don't really call those goals. I think that is a question to answer.
Okay, so what makes people feel proud of themselves?
The proud feeling of people can come from many different things. But from simple things that as say, many people have proven that just simply making your bed after you wake up will give you a sense of proud after you have done something. Or people who are only being proud after they achieve certain goals, such as mastering an instrument and getting a degree of some sort.
Welcome. If I need to go back to class and put the stop button for me.